Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making water crackers. Now that's a very thin cracker that is low fat that you can use for any purpose that you might need a cracker for. It could be something like a dip or maybe a soup or a salad, any of those things. We're going to start by using a food processor. Into that we're putting 2 cups of self-rising flour. So I have my first cup here and the second cup. If you don't have self-rising flour or don't want to buy that, having the other kind, then just use all-purpose flour, and for each cup of all-purpose flour, add 1½ teaspoons of baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon salt. To this flour, we're going to add just a pinch of salt, and I measured out a tiny portion so I could get a pinch in there. 1 tablespoon of olive oil. I'm using extra virgin olive oil. Now I'm going to put my lid on. And then I'm going to pulse this, or just let it mix a little. Now this is mixed, and don't expect it to come together in a ball yet because we've not added our liquid other than the olive oil, but I want to show you that it is mixed together very well. So now I have 1/2 cup of water. We're putting all of that in. And we're going to mix this again. Now you'll see that this is crumbly. It needs to come together into a ball. So I have some water that I have set out just to dribble in a little bit and mix and continue that process until it comes together in a ball. Looking in on it, I'm going to pick up some and squeeze it. If it will hold together, then it will be ready to go. And it does. So we're going to get this out and put it on a cutting board. And I might as well use my hands to make it a little more symmetrical. And what I plan to do is cut it into portions that are more manageable. So we'll just go down the middle here and down the middle here. Doesn't have to be perfect. So we have 4 portions, and each portion is going to be rolled out to be very thin. And if I do that on my counter, I won't be able to get it up. I'll maybe take a spatula, but it will all curl together and just not work. So what I'm going to do is use some parchment paper. I've got 2 sheets out here, and I should be able to reuse them, but I'm putting 1 of these portions down, and I'm flattening it out before I start rolling it because that will be helpful. And then put the top paper on and use a rolling pin to get it very thin. I've used 1/2 of the dough. I have my 2 pieces that I have not rolled yet. I don't think I'm going to do those right now, so I'm going to cover them tightly and put them in the refrigerator and then get them out some other time and bring them to room temperature and then go ahead like we have done here in the rolling. You can see that these are going to be shapes that are unusual. It doesn't matter. You're just trying to get it to be the same thickness everywhere. And at the very end, midway through, or you could even start by having the rolling pin on the top here and not have a paper over this. And that way you can see what you're doing more clearly, and also it doesn't crumple the paper so badly. So part of these were done one way and part the other way, but the goal was to get it as thin as possible and as even as possible, both of these. Now we can cut them. I have a little biscuit cutter, and this is about 2 inches across, so I think that will be nice and cute. But you can make these whatever size you want. I may have to twist a little bit here. Okay, so now we can get that one loose. And you want to take a fork and make some holes. So just prick it and then put it on a baking sheet. Now you should have a paper lined baking sheet, or in this case, you can have a Silpat. That way it's going to cook nicely and it will come off very readily without sticking to the bottom. So I have some work to do. I'm going to go ahead and put these in here and then we will bake them. I'm just going to bake one pan of these today, and you can see this is the pan where I used one of the rolled out pieces for these, I think, and these look a little bit thicker, so that may show up when we take them out of the oven. These go to a 400 degree oven, and it doesn't take them long. You look for them to get golden brown, and that should be within 10 minutes. We have our water crackers out of the oven, and I left them there for 8 minutes. And they did pretty well because they were in two batches of rolling. And these at the end are thicker because they were the second rolling, and I guess I was getting tired. And these are nice and thin and even. And that's what you want, and you want to see a little bit of golden brown around the edges. And that means they're going to be nice and crisp. So you can immediately remove them from the pan and put them on a nice serving plate. So we'll just go under these. And they should not be stuck in any way, so they will easily come out to your plate. So here we have a small portion of water crackers to serve, and I'm just going to help myself. This one looks nice and thin and crispy. There's a little air bubble. You expect those occasionally. And I'll come over here to where I have some lemon tea, so that should be delightful in the afternoon. So let's try it. That's what you get. It's pretty thin. And it's tasty, but not in the sense that it provides a lot of herbs or saltiness or cheese or anything like that. That's why it's so good to put this with, say, a cheese dip or something that has a lot of flavor. You still get the crispiness from the cracker and the use of the cracker, but it doesn't overpower anything. But I love the taste. And the crispiness. Enjoy.